गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न ई कम्युनिकेशन मॉड्यूल 5th पार्ट 1st, दैट इज द 5th मॉड्यूल फॉर योर ई कम्युनिकेशन, फॉर योर कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स फॉर BA सेकंड सेमिस्टर 4th. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ ई कम्युनिकेशन? बिफोर नोइंग what is the meaning of e-communication, all of you know what is the meaning of communication, as it is a process of transferring information, ideas, suggestions, orders, requests, feelings, etc. And in this particular module you are going to learn about the electronic mail and other things related to it. So first part, how communication is a process of transferring information, ideas, suggestions. In communication, one-way communication or one to more person communication, there is transferring of ideas, information, suggestions, orders, requests, feelings, plans, messages, grievances, etc. is important one for from one person to another or many, or from one group to another group. So in this particular module you are going to learn the e-communication, that is different modes of communication, that is there are in different modes of communication. Firstly, we learn in ancient times communication was done through messengers. Then there was the birth of post offices. However, with the advantage or advancements in science and technology, the spread of internet all over the world, of all of you know how the spread of internet is all over the world, and nowadays it is a part and parcel of our life. Without this internet, I can't take your lecture, and also you can't listen without internet. So in this particular module you are going to learn how to use the technology for the communication or use of communication. After advancement in technology and science, there emerged e-communication. In this particular unit, you are going to learn about email communication, email discussion groups, and email pals and blogs, about the blogs as well. In the next, that is electronic communication or e-communication, is a term used for communication by means of electronic media. All of you know what is the meaning of electronic media, that is your WhatsApp group, again Instagram, email, blogs, Facebook, Twitter, all those are used as a electronic media, that is use of internet, use of computer is important in e-communication. In e-communication, advanced techniques there are such as computer modems, facsimile machines, voicemail, electronic mail, teleconferencing, video cassettes, or private television networks are used. An easy and fast way to communicate with a person or group, that is electronic communication, is used term for communication by means of electronic media. It is an easy and fast way to communicate with a person or group. There are various advantages of e-communication like speedy transfer of messages, wide coverage, managing global access, exchange of feedback, reasonable cost, etc. Now, let us study some of the means and ways of e-communication and their uses. See, for your particular paper of business communication, it is a necessary part how to write an email and what is the format of email writing. Electronic mail or email, it is in short called as an email, is one of the most popular ways of communication using internet. It is delivered through electronic means and being transmitted electronically. Through email, one can send written messages, both textual and non-textual, information, pictures, and files. Messages sent and received by email can be stored and organized according to our needs. It is eco-friendly. One of the most important advantage of it, that is eco-friendly as it reduces the use of papers. We can save our data in computer. We can save our emails in computers by the use of internet and electronic media. This is the format of email. In it, we can understand how the particular page is pasted here. And you all of you know what is the format of email writing. But how it should be in detail and in particular manner, that's why I pasted this page here. That is to whom it is written. Again, if we want to send it to most of the people, we have to write down CC, that is carbon copy, addresses of other persons. Subject, email viruses. It is written about the email viruses and it is mailed to all staff. So, how it is written and what is the language of it? See, it is only the part of format. In the next lecture, next part, we will learn about what should be the language of it. Next, email address. The most essential thing in email communication is email address. All of you know what is the meaning of email address. That is how we are going to learn it. That is, email address include three part format: user ID at host dot domain. That is, the user ID is the name of the user. Again, @ sign, follow account name. After that, the host of the email account, with, for example, Gmail, Hotmail, Yahoo, etc. The domain, for example, .com, in, or .co, in, .net, etc. So, email address. As all of you know, email address is important for your exams, and all of you know how to write down or how to create an email. Next part, it is about the format of email in figure 1. That is, I pasted that figure for your understanding, and the caption from is sender's email address and is at the top. 2 is for the receiver's email address. CC means carbon copy, denotes the email address of the persons who you are to send the same mail to more than one person. By using this option, you can send the message. From to CC is important one. Same mail to many persons you would like to send. There is another option, BCC, which means add blind carbon copy, which allows the sender of the message to conceal the person entered in the BCC field from the other recipients. So this is about the email address writing, and firstly and this is the important part in the formal email writing. Next part is about the subject line. The subject line of the email is an important as the actual message. Why subject line is important? When the mail is received by the person, he or she can understand what is the particular subject of that particular email and what will be the written in the email. That is, subject line of the email is as important as the actual message. So it should be appropriate, short, concise, specific and clear. It gives a kind of hint or sign for your message. When people receive a number of messages, a catchy and meaningful subject line will attract and enable the receivers to see the mail. When you try to send an email without subject, you might have seen automatically generated reminder, "Would you like to your message to be sent without a subject line?" If you send me message without subject line, there will be a line, "Would you like to send your message without a subject line?" This itself defines the importance of subject line. So generally the keywords of the message are written in the subject line. Don't write subject line using all the capital letters. Here are a few examples of writing subject line. The examples, that is, request for information about submission of examination forms, inquiring about value added courses starting by the university, schedule for the October-November examination, regarding organization of youth festival, invitation of for birthday party, tour program to South India. So this is the subject line examples, and in this way you have to write down the subject line in your email address, in your email. Beginning and ending emails. What will be the beginning and ending of emails? Begin your email always with a proper salutation or greeting. It should be written taking into consideration whether the mail is formal or informal. Formal, it means official. You are going to write down according to your office rules, or in it might be about any office message, or informal, to your family members or friends. While writing informal or formal emails, use the proper beginning and ending. This is the important part for your email writing. Here are the example in your textbook, that is, beginning email, respected sir or madam. Informal email, dear Mr. Patil, hello sir or madam, or to whom it may concern. Informal email, that is, hi Tejaswini, hi dear sweet sister or sis, hello Baba, regards. Next, cheers. This is the beginning of the email of second part, informal email. Ending of the email, what will be the ending of email? Yours faithfully, yours sincerely, yours truly, or truly yours. In informal email, you might write down, see you again, bye bye, yours only, or yours lovely. This might be the ending of emails. Unlike complimentary clause in letter writing, the ending of email should be at the left side only. So this, you must know this, the difference between the particular mail writing and the letter writing. It is a customary style. Also, new paragraph is started without leaving space. Formal emails can be ended with the mention of your name, address, or designation. In the informal emails, there is no need of such details. You can just write your name. So, this is the pattern of email writing, and you must know what are the details in it. In the next part, we will learn about informal and formal email writing. Till then, thank you.